This is Dr. Rupali Shelke from Walchand Institute of Technology, working as an associate professor. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss on the wave equation in lossy media. In the previous video, we are discussed with the wave equation in a lossless media. After completion of this section, students are able to study or derive the wave equation in lossy media. They can represent the wave equation in phasor form. Also, they can solve the related problems. Now, let us consider a transverse electromagnetic wave traveling in a x direction, having the electric field in a y direction and magnetic field in a z direction, and wave is propagating in a x direction. This representation shows that the wave is transverse because the electric field and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other, as well as they are perpendicular to the direction of propagation. Now, pause the video. Recall what value we are considered for the conductivity for perfect dielectric media and free space. Yes, for perfect dielectric media and free space, the sigma value is equal to 0, and the epsilon, there is a variation in the epsilons and mu value. Similarly, the assumption for the lossy media and epsilon will depends on the media. Now, let us derive the wave equation for a lossy media. Now, consider a Maxwell's equation derived from the Faraday's law. That is, del cross E bar is equal to minus dou B by dou T. In this equation, dou by dou T will substitute as a J omega, that is a harmonically varying. And as we know the relation between the B and H, that is the value of B will be substituted as a mu H bar. Now, we will solve the equation expanding the curl product. It will be in a rectangular coordinate AX, AY and AZ, dou by dou X, dou by dou Z, EX, EY, EZ will be equal to minus J omega mu, the HX, HY and HZ. As we are assumed our wave propagating in a X direction, that's why the value of dou by dou X will not be equal to 0, and the electric field in a Y direction, that's why the value of EY will also be not equal to 0, and magnetic field in a Z direction, that's why HZ will also be not equal to 0, while other terms are, we are considering it as a 0. Now, after solving this determinant, the equation will reduce to dou by dou EY by dou X will be equal to minus J omega mu HZ. We will mark it as an equation 1. Similarly, let us consider a Maxwell's equation derived from the Ampere's law, which is nothing but a del cross H bar is equal to sigma E bar plus dou D by dou T, which is equal to the dou by dou T will substitute J omega, and the relationship between the E and D is D bar is nothing but epsilon E bar. We will substitute the value of D bar is equal to. If you see these equations, this is relating between the magnetic field and the electric field. Similarly, we will expand del cross H bar, and by same assumption, we will substitute the value here. In this case, dou HZ is not equal to 0 now, and EY will also be not equal to 0, while other terms we will substitute it as a 0, and by considering the common E bar, we will substitute the consider the equation sigma plus J omega epsilon into other terms. Now, solving this equation, we get minus dou HZ by dou X AY bar is equal to sigma plus J omega epsilon EY AY bar. Ay will be common, that's why the equation will reduce to dou hz by dou x will be equal to minus sigma plus j omega epsilon Ay. We will mark this equation as equation 2. We will use these equations and solve the next problem. Considering the equation 2, differentiate this equation 2 with respect to x, then it will be a second order derivation. Dou square hz by dou x square will be equal to this term as it is, the equation dou by dou Ey by dou x. We will mark it as an equation 3. Now substituting the value of dou Ey by dou x from the equation 1, we will get the equation dou square hz by dou x square is equal to j omega mu, which is the value of dou by dou x h. Here we will substitute this. If you see this equation, at the both the side LHS and RHS, we are having the value hz. That's why we are calling this as a wave equation for the lossy media in the magnetic field or hz term. Similarly, let us consider equation 1, which we are already derived. Differentiating equation 1 with respect to x, this will be a second order del square Ey by dou x square is will be equal to minus j omega mu here dou hz by dou x. We will mark it as an equation 4. Then substituting the value of dou hz by dou x from equation 2, this value now we will substitute in the equation 4, then the equation 4 will be in this way, which is nothing but a second order equation in a terms of electric field. This was in a magnetic term and this is in a electric term. This is a wave equation for the lossy media in Ey term. These both equations are also called as a Helmholtz equations in terms of hz. This term we can represent it in a phasor form by substituting the dou square del x by the del operator. As it is a second order, it will be a del square hz, and this term is equal to the propagation constant gamma square hz. If you see, this is a phasor equation. These both equations are in terms of hz term, that is in a magnetic field. Similarly, we can write the wave equation for a lossy media in terms of electric field. Pause the video, think for a while and try to solve this problem. In this case, a magnetic field is given in a form of equation which is in a wave direction, and the value for the mu r, epsilon r and sigma are given, and determine the value for the propagation constant, that is gamma, attenuation constant and beta. As this value, it is the equations are for the lossy media, the sigma is having some value. This is not equal to be 0, it is having some value. Therefore, it seems that when the waves are traveling into the free space in a lossless media, then there is no change in the amplitude, while when the waves are traveling in the lossy media, then there is a losses takes place or a attenuation takes place in the amplitude. There is a change in the amplitude variations, while other terms, that is a velocity, wavelength and beta, will remain same. These are the few references. Thank you.